Hello guys, welcome to my channel. So today we are going to create a Python script through which we can generate new views for our channel or for specifically on our videos that need views. So you can be as greedy as much possible. You can try to fetch as many views as you want. There is no limit, right? I have created a script through which you can generate even billions of views, right? And that's possible. So without wasting any time, let's just move into the code. But before we do that, if you are new to my channel, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do. And let's jump back to the video. So what we need to do is, first we need to pick out a video. So I'm going to use my channel here, and I'm going to pick a video, and on that video itself I'm going to generate views. So as you can see here, this HackerRank Java view, let me open this first. So this HackerRank Java valid username one has only one view right now. So you can click on analytics, and here you can see that it has only one view. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to copy the URL for this, right? And I'm going to hold on to this so that I can generate views. Now we are going to work on our script. So what we need to do is, we need to open idle, and you need one dependency only, which is Selenium. So I hope if you don't know about Selenium, you can work on that, but I'm going to let you know about the stuff that that we are going to use with Selenium. So first you just need to install Selenium using pip install command, right? Once you do that, you might be able to do something like this, right? If you don't see any error, that means that it is installed perfectly good. If you see any error, that means that you don't have it installed yet, so please do. Now you need second thing, which is not exactly any sort of library, but it's like a driver so that you can open your Chrome. So first what you need to do is, you need to find out what version of Chrome are you using. So to do that, you have to click on this, and then you have to go to help, and then about Google Chrome. So when you click on that, you can see the version that I'm using is this one, right? Then you have to go to this official URL, Chrome driver. You can directly have a Google search like Chrome driver download, and it will pop this URL up or search. And you need to find out this specific driver for a specific Chrome version, and you download this driver. So when you download this, it gets downloaded in a zip file. So let me download this for you. So see here, there are options. So you have to download your corresponding Windows one. So I'm using Windows 64, and here only I see Windows 32. So I'll download this, because 64 can run both 32 and as well as 64. Then I'll just open this up. Let me open it. Okay. So here you see a exe file. So if you try to open this exe, it won't do much, but let me do it anyway, right? So what we need to do is, we need to use this Chrome driver along with our Selenium so that we can actually do our stuff. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put this in my desktop so that I can show you exactly what I'm doing. So this exe file is here now. Now we need to create a new file. So now what we need to do, again, we need only two things, Selenium and our driver. So only one thing, actually one library. So I need few stuff from Selenium, so I'm going to import them specifically. So first I need a web driver, which is again going to use Chrome driver. Then I'm going to use Selenium dot web driver dot support dot UI, and then I'm going to import web driver. Wait, so this is an important one, right? And then we are going to use, I'll come down to this, like why we need this, but first let's import Okay, so the import part for Selenium is done, right? Now we need two things. First is we need time and OS, which is I think really common. Now we need to create a function, but I'll create that function later. First let's write down the code. So first what I need is I need an instance of Chrome. So what I will do is I'll just use WebDriver method, and then I'll do dot Chrome, and here I have my browser. Now I need a URL, and you remember I copied that from the YouTube. Sorry, in a bad habit of using Java. And oh, it's not copied anymore. Let me copy again and paste it here. Right, now we just need to open this using get method, and here I'll just do URL. So in your case you just have to change this up, rest code will be similar. Now what we need is we need to use our web driver wait method. Like I said, it's an important one. So why we need this is when you open any URL. So let me do one thing, let me just run it till here. So desktop, and let's do views automation and run this. Okay, I made a stupid mistake. Okay, let's run it now. So it is going to use our Chrome driver to open an instance of Chrome, and here you can see that we got the video open, but it's not playing the video, right? You can see that still holds one view, but when I click on this, then only it is going to play this video. So now I have to work on that play part, right? So what do we need actually? How do we do that? Again, like I said, we need WebDriver wait, but again, for what stuff? So if you run this code again, I'll explain why we need and what do we do. So first we need to find out in this page which button to click. So we need to find out this specific button identification. So to do that, you just have to click on this inspect. And when you do, you can change the doc size. So I prefer it this way. And then I'm going to select an element like this. So when you click on this, you can see that this is an area label play. So if I try to find out area label play, I just have to click on it. And through that, I'm going to be able to play this video. But I need some kind of buffer time so that it can retry within those seconds. Like let's say you are doing this in an iteration of let's say 1 billion, so you need some kind of buffer time in your account so that in case some video or some iteration is taking longer than needed, then it is having that buffer time, right? So for that purpose specifically, we are going to use WebDriver wait. So let me write down that code. So now I have my browser instance, so I'll just provide the buffer time as 15. So this is like you can see like poll frequency timeout. So this is my timeout here, 15, right? And then I'm going to do this until EC, which is expected conditions dot element to be clicked, and you know which element is clicked, which is R. So first I need to find that out using XPath, right? And then here I'm going to provide that element, so it's a button, right? And then to identify that button, we need to provide here at symbol, which is for the specific element, which is area label equals to play. That is what we saw by inspecting, right? Now afterwards, what we need to do is we just need to do click, but first let me close this bracket up and then do dot click. So now let's try to run and see if it is working or not. So let me close this browser as well as this one, right? Okay, did I put extra bracket? Okay, so the problem is that we are using the wrong brackets. Okay, let's run this now. So as you can see, it's working and it will play for as much duration as you want, right? But again, I don't want it to be run for 728, right? I just want it to click on it so that I can get a view and then I can close this up. So I estimated like around 5-6 seconds are needed for this 7 minutes long video to get a view. But again, it depends on the video duration also. Like if you are having a 30 plus minutes video, you may need 10 plus seconds to work on that, right? So again, you can experiment as much as you can, but for me, like 10 seconds 11 seconds is like an average kind of thing for each and every video. So again, you can do that. And now what we have to do is we need to close this up after getting a view, which according to me is a 10 seconds difference. Like when the video gets played for around 10 seconds, I need to close that browser, right? So let's do that. How should we do that? It's simple. We just have to use time.sleep method for 10 seconds, and after that's completed, we just have to quit our browser. So browser.quit. And that's it, right? So let's do this. So you can count the seconds, but you can also view the seconds here. So after 10 seconds, it is going to get closed. So as you can see, it got closed, right? This is what you can do. In case you see that your Chrome driver window is opening up, that's because you are using close method here, not quit, right? So you have to use quit method. And this is what we have to do specifically for getting view. Now to run this on an iteration, you just have to create a method. So I'm going to name this specifically related to my work. So this is going to create views. So that's why it's create views. Now I'm going to put this all up inside my method. So indentation. Now my method is created. I just need to call it. So you can create an infinite loop using while true, but again, I cannot show you that because it's going to be an infinite video. So I'll just do a counter here. So I'll just do I less than 5. So I'm going to generate 5 views here. I'm going to initialize I with 0, and here I'm just going to increment I, and after incrementing or before incrementing, I can call the method create views. And at the end also, just to check if everything worked out, you can print I also, right? So let's do this again. Like I said, you can create an infinite loop to get more views, right? So let's run this. See, it got completed and I can see that it ran 5 times. So now it amounts to 5 views. So now let's check the views. So I'll just go back, hit refresh. So if you see this number not exactly similar to what you did, it's because YouTube takes a while. I don't know why, but it takes a while to refresh that count. So here you see 5, but it should be more than that. So I'm going to keep refreshing till I see that, or I can show you that this script worked. Okay, so I think this is the final outcome. So I think I started at 4 views and now it amounts to 9 views. So the script worked perfectly. Now I'm sure like you are not going to run it for 5 iterations, and I hope you are working or running this for more iterations. So it is going to give you a lot more views, right? And again, this is all that you have to do. This is the exact code that you have to do. So if you see any problem in this code, do comment that out in the comment section for this video, and let me know if you need any more help. But I'm pretty sure like this script is going to work with you, and you can get as many views as you want. So I created specifically this script for me, but again, I like to give out the knowledge as much as I can. So I'm going to end this video, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, have a good day and stay safe, and bye bye.